Hey guys, how's it going? In this video, I'm going to talk about SAP CPI Message Model. Because you need to understand how SAP CPI handles messages internally when you send a message between a sender participant and a receiver participant. In this video, I'll briefly talk about what is Apache Camel's data model and how it is used in SAP CPI for handling messages. Then I'll talk about what are the main elements of Apache Camel's data model, like headers, attachments, body, and exchange. Then I will explain what are the parallel functions that you can use in SAP CPI to handle these message segments. And finally, I'll try to explain how these messages can be handled by using a simple Groovy script. Without further delay, let's get started. As you all know, SAP CPI has been implemented on top of Apache Camel, which is an open source integration framework. SAP CPI uses Apache Camel as a core engine to process messages of any format such as XML, JSON, CSV, EDI, and other formats. Apache Camel allows you to use various domain-specific languages such as Java, XML, Groovy to define the routes and expressions. That is the reason why, as a CPI developer, you better know Java language or Groovy scripting to better work with SAP CPI component. Let's talk about what are the main elements of SAP CPI message. In SAP CPI, the message is composed of headers, attachments, and body. Headers are nothing but a key value pair that contains information related to the messages such as sender, receiver, content type, correlation ID, and etc. Body is the main payload of the message, which contains the business related data that is being transferred. A body can be of any type such as XML, JSON, CSV, EDI, and etc. Attachments are optional data that can be attached to the message such as files, images, documents, and etc. In my one of the real-time examples, I already covered how can you handle attachments in email server in Groovy scripting. Please check that video. And the last element of SAP CPI data model is exchange. An exchange is a data container that represents a message exchange process between two endpoints. Basically, an exchange contains a message, which is header, attachments, and a body, as well as some properties and history. Exchange actually encapsulates the messages that are being transferred between a sender and receiver participant. Apache Camel is developed using Java language, which means Apache Camel's message model can be represented by using Java interfaces and Java classes and Java objects. Let me now explain what are the classes and interfaces that are responsible for all the elements of Apache Camel's message model. As you can see in this picture, so we have message that holds headers, attachments, and body. Let's now map these elements to Java classes and interfaces. For example, the message is represented by using an interface called org.apache.camel.message. Headers are represented by using a key value pair, where key can be any string, which is java.lang.string, or value can be any object, which is java.lang.object. Similarly, attachment can hold any type of file. It can be PDF or it can be CSV or any object. That's why it's represented by using a object class, which is java.lang.object. And finally, we have body, which is actually contains the payload of your message. This is also represented by using a object class, which is java.lang.object. Finally, we have exchange that holds both inbound message and outbound message together with exceptions and properties. This exchange can be represented by using an interface called org.apache.camel.exchange. Let's now learn how you can manipulate these message model elements in SAP CPI by using different palette functions. In SAP CPI, you can use palette functions like content modifier and Groovy script to manipulate the elements of your message model. Let me show you how we can use these palette functions in SAP CPI. As you can see here, I have created a sample integration process in SAP CPI, where I added a palette function called content modifier. In the property section of content modifier, you can see message header, exchange property, and message body. Under the message header, I created a variable called invoice, which is of type string, and I am reading that from inbound payload by using element called invoice number. And I'm using a source type called XPath, which means I'm reading the value of invoice number by using XPath, and I'm storing the value in the message header. Let's now create an exchange property. Under the exchange property, I have already created a variable called payload. This payload is derived by using an expression, and the value is coming from body, and it is of type string, which means this payload that holds a value of the body, and it is created in the exchange property. Finally, let's now create message body. Under the message body section, you can use type expression. In the body, I am creating a body of response. I am creating a response body by combining header property and exchange property. So I am combining invoice and payload to create a body. So this is how you can use content modifier to manipulate message header, exchange property, and message body. When you use content modifier, you can use different types of source type, which means you need to indicate what is the source of your variable. For example, you can define a constant, you can use an expression, or you can use global variables or local variables. You can also use header, and you can also use number range, and you can also use property, and you can use XPath to read a value from a XML payload. Similarly, in SAP CPI, you can use script palette function, which is a groovy script palette function, to manipulate the elements of your SAP CPI message model programmatically. If you want to learn how you can use groovy scripting in SAP CPI, please watch my other videos, the real-time example 3 and real-time example 4, where I explained how you can manipulate message payload by using groovy scripting. So this is it. This is about SAP CPI message model. Hope you learned something new in this video. If you learned something new and if you like the video, please give a like, subscribe to my channel and share with your friends. And thank you for watching.